battle to get to it, but he's a big man and he can hit hard. He's a clean hitter. And when Willie's out there, people just give him a little bit more room because they know he's going to come barreling into them. And Willie does it most effectively in the forechecking role.
Acton against Walder. And the Canadians control. This is Ludwig. Makes his home in Eagle River, Wisconsin in the offseason. Now Bellows. Whoa, did he smack Walder down to the ice. And the Canadians clear it into the North Star end. Good solid check by another strong man, Ryan Bellows. Here's Dirk Graham. Pass tipped by Richie. Acton has it. He's hauled down. Play goes on. Graham backhands one. Hayward makes the save. Then Graham and Gingras go at it almost here. Graham has thrown the gloves off. Gingras has two. Long range blow thrown there. And now Lemieux and Grundstrom.
Lemieux throwing some rights, uppercuts, and some crosses to the helmet of Grindstrand. Dirk Graham was grabbed onto initially by Chelios. Now Grindstrand being worked over by Claude Lemieux. Finally tumbles to the ice. And now Ryan Walter trying to get on top. The whole thing started, Frank, with a third Montreal player trying to get in at Dirk Graham.
Everybody is paired off. Only Gingras has been escorted to the box by Ron Finn. And Finn is now finally making his way back to the pile, the rest of the players.
Now it's Richie pinning. Who is that? Grindstrand to the ice?
Or Hartsburg?
No, it's Woody Acton.
Jerseys have been pulled up over his shoulders, and it was very difficult for a while from our vantage point to tell who is who. There's your look at Claude Lemieux, and he gets quite an ovation.
He threw so many punches, he's got a cut hand. And I'm sure he threw so many punches that Grundstrand thought he was surrounded.
Lemieux had 145 minutes in penalties in just 58 games in the American League last year. Now Grundstrand and Richie are having a few words. Jerry Grundstrand doesn't want any part of that.
Well, Bellows is trying to, actually Richie is challenging Bellows. Bellows, meanwhile, is being tied up. Is that Ludwig?
Yeah.
Now, Dirk Graham has been taken right off the ice and going to the North Stars dressing room.
Keith Acton apparently has been cut a bit. There's some blood look like it's coming from his lower lip or across his chin. Quite a bit, as a matter of fact. And now Richie and Bellows.
Now there's an instigator. Richie has been waltzing around here for the last 2 minutes, taunting and taunting. Now if that doesn't get a penalty call, then why did we go through all this rule stuff? But it's going to be very interesting to see how this is all meted out. There's a bloody Keith Acton.
Barking out right now at Ryan Walter. There's Walter on the right of your screen.
Lemieux is hurt, too. He's leaving the ice.
Tell you. Now Bellows and Richie at center ice are squared off, but Ron Asselstein won't let him go. Asselstein, the biggest linesman in the league.
They just guide the thug off the ice. That's the safest way to stop this. The inexperience of referee McCreary is showing right now because he should be over there telling Richie, get out.
Which Richie finally does there. This is making for a bitterly long night already.
Six goals against, five straight by the Canadians have made it long enough. And now it's going to take, I'm sure, quite a while to get this all figured out. I think, really, McCreary might be safe in just giving minors to everybody in that case.
Well, there's blood drawn on Acton, and they'll have to determine how that happened, I suppose. And and the new rules are going to get a severe test here.
Well, especially an old rule that's been on the books for a long time, and that happened when Graham first got paired off with one of the Canadians, and a third man came into the altercation. Now try and figure out who's there.
Why do you think they started putting numbers on them? Acton, the former Canadian, drawing a chorus of boos, but a few cheers also from the fans here.
Looks like Doc Rose and company are going to keep busy on the Minnesota side, as will the Canadian training staff.
Well, Bill McCreary and his linesmen are still sorting things out. Live from the Montreal Forum, it's North Stars Hockey on KITN-TV, Channel 29. I was just looking over Claude Lemieux's record a little further. He's racked up a fair amount of penalty minutes here in his career. 225, 152, and 145 in the Quebec League. Then last year with the Canadians, he had 22 minutes and 10 regular season games, and another 68 and 20 playoff games.
Well, there's no question he's tough, and that was, I think, a big element in the Canadian success last year, was to have a young guy like that come into the lineup, was a spark plug because of his youthfulness and also the tenacity in which he plays the game. And he is a disturber, likes to get things going, and he can also handle himself extremely well. He proved that a couple of times in the playoffs last year. And he's rapidly making a very good name for himself as a customer you don't really want to reckon with. And I'm sure Yari Granstrand really won't be looking for Claude Lemieux in further meetings between the North Stars and the Canadiens.
Just to give you an idea of what the league has done this year is a brief summary of their change in the fisticuff rules as written by the league office. In addition to a major penalty for fisticuffs, the instigator of an altercation will now be further penalized with a minor, major, and or game misconduct. A player assessed a minor and major penalty under this new rule on two occasions in a game will receive an automatic game misconduct penalty, while any player assessed an additional major penalty under this rule on one occasion will also receive a misconduct. Here's how it all started, and then we'll give you the announcement on the penalties.
You see Dirk Graham going into the corner boards, tied up along the wall there with Gaston Gingras. They do some pushing. Now watch the third man come in here. Well, we just went to a different camera shot just prior to that, but I believe it was number 44, Stéphane Richer, who had come in and threw the first punch before Graham was allowed to get loose and start swinging it out with Gingras. Bill McCreary, a youthful referee, having his hands full in this particular occurrence.
Let's pick up Claude Moutin if we can.
Here's Stéphane Richer.
The penalty is to Minnesota, number 21, third Graham. 5 minutes for fighting, 10 minutes misconduct, and a game misconduct penalty. Number 5, Yari Granstrand, 5 minutes for fighting. Number 23, Brian Bellows, a 10 minutes misconduct penalty. To the Canadians, number 29, Gaston Gingras, 5 minutes for fighting. Number 32, Claude Lemieux, 2 minutes for...
Canada didn't have a chance. 6-3 Canadians at that point. They won the game 6-4. There was a bit of this business as well, which led to the ejection of three players, all started, according to the referee and anyone who watched it, by Claude Lemieux.
Comment le tout est arrivé?
Bien, je pense que c'est durant la bagarre. Lorsque je suis tombé sur la patinoire, il y a un joueur qui s'amenait, puis je me suis fait couper au doigt.
Et comment est-ce que ça s'est produit, cette bagarre-là? C'est toi qui as engagé ça?
Bien, tout le monde s'est pris un homme lorsque c'est arrivé dans le coin de la patinoire, et puis le gros bonhomme semblait vouloir laisser tomber les gains, puis c'est moi qui ai engagé le combat. J'avais un joueur qui était nommé Hartsburg qui me tenait par en arrière, puis j'en ai demandé, j'en avais deux sur le dos, c'est ça qui a fait que je me suis coupé sur le doigt.
That brawl that Claude Lemieux was involved in last night led to a cut hand, stitches, and as a result, he won't play in Buffalo tomorrow night in the next Canadiens game. Lemieux was ejected from the game in the battle with the Minnesota North Stars, also picked up an extra 2 minutes for being the fight's instigator.